morning, Russell. Would you like a cup of tea?
Yes, please. Milk and two sugars.
There we are.
Thanks a lot.
This was more like it. The paddle steamer Emmy Lou. Millions of gum trees. 6 days on board to go. So doubtless there'd be billions more. What's happening in the real world outside? Can I survive without television?
Only 28 cows in bull's pen, making it difficult to give a reliable quote. Number two heavy Friesian cows made 69.
Fascinating. Strange how one always looks forward to trips like this and almost immediately finds oneself bored, witless. Maybe a bath would help. Emmy Lou is a replica of the old-time paddle steamer. She was built to carry tourists up and down a 100-mile stretch of the Murray. She offers those passengers the simplicity of life on the river combined with the pleasures of an expensive restaurant. This first sumptuous breakfast completely restored my morale and my excitement about the voyage to come. I chartered the Emmy Lou to take me about 200 river miles from Barmer to Swan Hill, a journey the locals said was impossible because it hadn't been done since the 50s. Nowadays, they warned, there were unmapped snags, overhanging cables, and a low-slung bridge waiting to wreck us. This old engine obviously didn't share the doubts of the locals. Discovered in the bush, 50 miles from the river, it's been lovingly restored and looks indomitable. It was steam engines like this that helped open up inland Australia. They conquered the vast distances and, on this river, powered the paddle boats which made the Murray a highway. This old boat, Pevensey, is the genuine article. A river work boat from the days when the river was the only means of moving cargo. Today, she's skippered by a pharmacist from Echuca, and she carries tourists on day trips. In earlier days, her passengers would have been much stouter hearted. For 80 years, until the Depression ruined everyone, the rivermen were Australia's real pioneers. Almost all of them were emigrants from the United Kingdom. They came to a hard land, and in most cases, they were harder. They had to be. The Murray could be cruel. In some seasons, she'd flood, then for years, run almost dry. Eventually, her soporific charm subdued whatever pioneering spirit may otherwise have survived. The river trade died, steamers with it, railways bypassed it, and the Murray became little more than an irrigation canal. The Murray's not an awesome river like the Mississippi, not mysterious like the Amazon, yet with its legion gum trees, sentinels lining its entire length, is strangely soothing. If the river soothes, the urban soul, steam seems to arouse in it an atavistic passion. Paul, our engineer, left Sydney to run this engine. He feeds it, cleans it, burps it, and is unashamedly proud of it. And properly so. Ancient this engine may be, but fueled with wood from the riverside forests and powered by steam, superbly efficient, and so simple that even I can understand it. This metropolitan creature suddenly had been smitten by the river's insidious charm. Anthony Brown had been obsessed by it for years and had built Emmylou to gratify his obsession. Like most of today's river entrepreneurs, he'd been drawn to it rather than born on it. Day 3 aboard Emmylou, and the preparation of my 7th sumptuous meal. But I hadn't chartered Emmylou in the expectation of constantly recurring haute cuisine. I'd chartered her because Anthony Browell and his piratical crew were the only river people mad enough to risk the journey I had to make to Swan Hill. Chris, the chef, I once had cooked at the Savoy, but faced with a voyage that could easily end in disaster, he flambéed on regardless. The outbreak of World War III, I now realize, couldn't have persuaded Anthony to abandon this trip.
Thanks, John. Is he going to get any?
No.
Is there something magnetic about this river that draws people to it?
Well, it's the only large river here. Put it like that. I mean, it's the only one where you can go for 100 miles, 200 miles. There is no other alternative. But the Murray is, people say the mighty Murray. Well, it never seems mighty to me. It seems, it's majestic, it's rough, it's crude, it's rude, but it's nice.
Secretive.
Very secretive, yes.
This had its moments on this trip when it's been all those things. But I find it, no. I do find it unexpectedly majestic in a way. Maybe that's because it's in flood now.
Yes, of course, it's very high now, and it's nice and wide.
It can look a bit daggy, can't it, when the water's low?
When it's low, it looks daggy. You've got the snags everywhere, the trees, mud. But that's all part of what the Murray is about. The Murray is a major drain to the inland. So
this is the longest trip your boat's ever done, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes, said Anthony with great calm. But immediately ahead, at Barham, almost halfway down the river, lay the first of our apparently insuperable problems. Because the river was in flood, and Emmylou's superstructure tall, it was impossible for us to steam beneath these overhanging cables. Officialdom had promised savage reprisals if we so much as touched one of them. the locals had cheerfully assured us that they weighed 22 immovable tons. Suddenly, it seemed likely that our great river journey was doomed to end before it was even half done.
Got another problem. If the boat breaks that cable, it could go anywhere. If you're anywhere near it, you're going to get your head knocked off.
What's the light as it comes down?
Despite the obvious dangers, Anthony and Skipper John were quite determined to have a bash. Anthony watched in stoic silence. We've done it. But ahead, much more dangerous lay the bridge, upon which, still cheerfully anticipating disaster, crowded the rest of Barham's school children who'd been given the morning off, and its entire adult population. Stern first, like an infant descending a flight of stairs, we crawled towards destruction, impelled by a river running at a good 11 miles an hour. If she had to, could Emmylou possibly retreat in time? The crowd egged us on. That funnel had to be too tall, and when it toppled, it would demolish half the wooden superstructure.
No, she's not going to make it under these cross braces.
Anthony's daring had been vindicated. We were through.